a million off my checklist 3 years ago. At 2 zeros to the one, I'm in a different mode. It's my life, do what I want, I be with different hoes. You know the pick and roll, I picked her up and sent her home. I got rich, I scrum, we get them in and get them gone. You know Trappy just got out, I ain't have to put them on. We the ones who got the numbers to put the city on. It's the middle of the summer, I got a hoodie on. My demon time ain't nothing nice, I try not to wear nothing tight. I came up off a shoe.
Yo, what's up guys, welcome back. I know it's been a while, probably like, I think a month, nah, not a month. All right, it's been a while, but long story short, a lot of you might be participating in this, what's going on right now for at least what I'm doing. So it's Ramadan. So pretty much I'm not eating from sunrise to sunset for religious reasons. There's a lot more to it, but I don't know if I talked about this before, but I mean, it's been tough because I haven't been getting a lot of sleep. I've been eating the same amount, just at a different time of the day. Workouts, I'm working out at night, but just balancing out work and my coaching and then trying to do, you know, the videos and everything week to week. It's been kind of tough, but gonna get back into it. Today I want to go through a short back workout, a few back workouts I've been doing this past month that I want to share with you guys. Also want to talk a little bit more about Ramadan, and for those, I know it's a little late, but just talking about things you can kind of do to get through this month and still stay on top of your fitness goals, whether you're bulking or, I don't want to talk too much about strength because that's not my specialty, but just things you can kind of do to stay, you know, on pace with what you've already been doing or even advanced during this time. Or if you're looking to get into the gym, things you can do to kind of get yourself, you know, into the rhythm of things during this time as well. So hopefully this helps out. If you guys have any questions, drop them down in the comments down below and stay tuned and enjoy. All right, so for me personally, I usually try to cut down during this time, during the summertime, but I don't know if you know me personally or if you've been following me on social media, you probably know that I messed up my ACL earlier this year. So because of that, it was kind of tough to bulk up the right way. I wasn't able to kind of move around the way I wanted to earlier this year. So I just had to just stay stagnant, maintain what I already had. So I was around like 173. Right now I'm around like 178. So I didn't really gain that much weight. Usually I'll bulk up like 15, 20 pounds. But I'm using this time to cut down a little bit. I want to cut down maybe 5 pounds, 5 to 10 pounds for the summer. Just maintain that, because it's, for me, that's very easy to maintain with how I like to eat and move around. So I would say if you're trying to cut down, this is a very good time because your eating window is so small. So if you're living in the East Coast where we are right now, you break your fast around like 8 o'clock and you have to start fasting again around 4 a.m. So you have whatever, I'm really bad at math, whatever that number of hours is. And you're going to be sleeping for most of those hours too. So use that to your advantage. You're not going to have a lot of time to snack. You might be even working out during that time. So cut another 2 hours out of that time if you're with family, if you're praying, whatever the case is. You're not gonna have much time. So pace yourself, don't eat all at once. Pace yourself during that time, but use that small window to your deficit if you are cutting. So now for the opposite, say you're trying to gain weight and put on muscle. Obviously the opposite, you're gonna be in a caloric surplus. You're gonna be eating more. Regardless of whatever your goal is, track, because this time is very easy to eat random stuff, because once you're able to eat after not eating for 16, 17 hours, you're gonna wanna eat whatever's in front of you. So really control yourself as far as that comes. Yeah, you can throw those in, but as long as you're tracking and staying on track with whatever your goals are, whether you're bulking or cutting, you should be good to go. It might be a little more tough when it comes to being in a caloric surplus, again, because the window of eating is so small. But again, I would say pace yourself. I don't really believe in like metabolism and eating every 3 hours, whatever the case is. Regardless, even if that is true, it's not going to apply during this month. So pace yourself, eat a lot of protein, eat a lot of carbs, keep it even if you can. And if you're working out, it's going to all balance itself out. But you want to avoid being, you know, too bloated. It's going to happen every now and then, but as long as you're pacing yourself, as long as you're tracking, eating the right stuff, you should be good to go. So if you're new to the gym, this is actually a really good time. So in general, creating a habit usually takes 3 to 4 weeks. So what, Ramadan's 30 days. So if you're set on what kind of goal you want to start during this month in the beginning and apply yourself to it and stay consistent, you're going to see a lot of change when it comes to the gym or anything else in general. It's very easy to kind of organize your time during this time because everything's kind of already set for you, right? When you're able to start eating, when you're able to stop eating, and all that good stuff. So I would say if you're new to the gym or if you're kind of getting back into the rhythm of things, this is a very good time to start because you don't really have outside distractions to get you off on track. Number one for diet, because that's one of the biggest things of this month. And then number two with training. Whether you're working out at home or at the gym, it's very easy to organize your time. So just use it to your advantage because you're not going to get this time back. But yeah, I would say if you're new, or if you're trying to get back into the rhythm of things, just get started. That's my advice. So in my personal opinion, the hardest part about Ramadan, aside from all the religious things that go on during this time, is your energy levels and your sleep. Those are the two areas that have been hitting me hard this month. Because usually I'm someone who likes to wake up around a certain time and go to sleep around a certain time, especially during the work week because I have so much going on. So during this time, I get thrown off track. But I would say power naps are going to be key. That's one thing. I usually never take naps, but if I'm really feeling it, especially during the work week, I'll try to at least get, I don't know, like 20, 30 minutes every now and then, here and there during the day just to get me back on track. And just like I pace myself during eating, another thing I try to do is pace myself with sleeping again with the power naps. And then really just using my energy wisely. So I know that I don't want to work out while I'm fasting. Although a lot of people that are watching this might be something that you already do or practice. I personally don't like doing it, but I'm not gonna tell you not to do it. I just, from the research I've done, I've seen that there's a lot of implications when it comes to injuries, and I'd rather just stay away from injuries after my fair share. Again, I like having just water in my body, having food in my body when I'm working out, and those are things you can't have when you're fasting. So I just feel I've done both, but after comparing both, that's just what I benefited more from, is waiting till later in the night. But these are just things that go on during this time. Try to stay on track as far as your vitamins, macros, always sleep. Sleep might be a little, you know, slacked off, but you'll get it back after 30 days. But yeah, hopefully these tips help out. It's something that we're all going through. Most importantly, I mean, if you're doing it for religious reasons, really try to put forward more effort for that stuff, because again, this is a very good time to do that. But hopefully the back work, as I shared with you guys, helps out. And if you guys have any more ideas for things for me to talk about, drop it down in the comments down below, and I'll talk to you soon.